Earlier, we've talked about equilateral triangles and equiangular triangles. And we had this theorem from the first day's notes. A triangle is equilateral if and only if it is equiangular. So here we have an equilateral triangle. We can tell because of the congruence marks. And so that means each of these three angles must be congruent. So if all of the angles add up to 180 and three are congruent, then 180 divided by 3 is 60 degrees. So each of the angles in an equilateral triangle, equiangular, are 60 degrees. So let's take a look at this theorem a little bit more and apply it to some problems. So right now, this triangle, well, what kind of triangle is it? We have congruent angles, angle R and angle T. And what that tells me is I have an isosceles triangle for sure. It's guaranteed to be an isosceles triangle. And in particular, since these are base angles, then RT is the base. And so RS and ST would be the congruent legs. So let's solve for Y. And we can only use those pieces of information to solve for Y, right? Because they're, even though it's tipped on its side, those are the legs of the isosceles triangle. So since legs are congruent, 6y plus 5 is equal to 7y minus 13. So let's solve for y. First, let's subtract 6y from both sides, and then add 13 to both sides. So we have y is equal to 18. Now, if y is equal to 18, and it says we're to classify this triangle by its sides, well, we know for a fact that it's an isosceles triangle, because these base angles were congruent. However, it's possible, remember, an isosceles triangle could potentially be an equilateral triangle if all three sides are congruent. And so let's take this value of 18 for y and substitute that value in for each of these three side lengths. So sub in y equals 18 for these three sides. So for each of these, 6 times 18 plus 5, that's 113. 7 times 18 minus 13 is also 113. Not a surprise there, because those are the congruent legs in an isosceles triangle. But this blue statement, 5 times 18 plus 23, is also equal to 113. And so what that tells me is all three of the sides are congruent to each other. And so triangle RST, it's not just isosceles, it's actually equilateral.